Hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to today's video where I'm going to show you two looks with the newest palette from Sigil inspired, the, I'm just going to call it the Chestnut Toad. And if you're new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And if you love makeup just as much as I do, if you want to hear about brands that no one else is talking about, if you want to be inspired by unusual color combinations, and if you just want to have plain old fun again, then this is the channel for you. Subscribe now, become part of my nestlings, because we are having a blast here on the internet. We are still having a band. We are Nightmare Before Christmas. I have to get the elephant out of the room, even though it's a tiny room and a big elephant. Never mind. This look is not done with this palette, and you will understand in a minute why. Basically, I was editing the video and I found out that I forgot to film the intro. So that is why you're getting this look, which is done with this palette from Nomad Cosmetics. That video is coming, I hope tomorrow, yeah, or the day after. But the Sigil Toad palette, that's why you clicked on the video. Now, usually I have a nice close-up, but I also forgot apparently to film that, so I'm just going to show you the palette up close, which has been used, yes, but it is very much like the rest of her palettes. I have the full size, as you can see. It is just a very nice, dark, grungier palette. Yeah, basically, how is this video built up? Oh, let me also show you the swatches while I'm talking to you anyway. How is the video built up? It is two looks, and at the end of the video I'll give you my thoughts, and I also have not specific comparisons, but additions too, because I feel that this palette pairs very, very well with some of her earlier palettes. So that is what I'm going to show you at the end of the video as well. I had a lot of fun creating the looks. I think that they came out beautifully. Without further ado, let's just get into the rest of the video. Grab a drink and a snack, put your feet up, because here comes look number one with the Sigil Toad palette. Okie dokie. I have primed my eyes with my Natasha Denona base. There are only two mattes in here, so it's not going to be that complicated, is it? Let's start with maybe a one-colored crease or something. I'm going to start with the darker brown. So I have some kick up in the pan, which is okay. I don't mind it. I'm really tapping off my brush. And I'm going to tap on the first layer very lightly. I'm going to blend it a little to get a nice soft fade. Tap on a little bit more. Blend it a bit. And then a slightly smaller brush. And I'm just going to build up the shade. So instead of grabbing another one for in the crease, I'm just grabbing the same shade. And you can also do it the other way around. So basically start lower and then blend it up and out. I just prefer to work a little bit differently. Let's go to a smaller brush. And just really pack it on in the outer corner and a little bit in the crease. And underneath my eye. Okay, shimmer time. I'm going to go to this shimmer first. Okay, let's see what it does dry. Ooh, that's nice. Fallout, yes, but very, very pretty. Ooh, I like this. So it's almost it almost kind of looks like the same color that I have on my eye, but then in a shimmer, huh? And a little bit darker. Now I'm going to spray. Oh, very pretty. So it doesn't make it a whole heap more intense. It just helps with the fallout a bit. I'm going to spray it and I'm going to tap it on top of my, well, basically my lower lash line. Then I'm going to go back to that brownie matte. And help blend this darker shade a little bit, because I put it up a little bit too high. Just going to blend it a little bit more into the upper layers, because apparently we're going for a little bit of a more, I don't know, shiny upper lid today. Where's the it may not be a surprise what color I want in the inner eye part. I wanted the green. I'm just going to fade it on top of that brown as well. It's dry, by the way. And then a little bit of the previous shade, just to make sure that the blend is nice and that I don't have any harsh lines. Pretty. Let's spray it for the other eye. Let's see. Doesn't matter. Nice and dark and gloomy. I got a loose, one of her loose pigments as well with my order. So let me open it up and put it in the inner corner because it's a little bit of a yellow. And I think it will complement this look very well. It is called Citrone Bart. Just taking a little bit of the cap. Oh yeah. Oh, this goes very, very well. Okay, let me finish the look off and then I will be back and show you the finished look. I finished off the look with a golden liner from LA Girl in the shade Goldmine. Falsies are from Babydoll in style 723. Lippy is from Lethal Cosmetics in the shade Arrival. And this is it for look number one. I really, really like it. Let me know down below what you think of this look. And let's get ready for look number two. Okay, look number two. And I'm going to start with the reddish shade that I've also used as a blush today. But I also used as a blush the previous look. Switching to a smaller brush. I'm just going to build up the shade a little bit more, but then a little lower. And then lightly blending the edges. The less I move my eyelid, the better. I'm going to go to the brown to deepen everything up. Cleaning my brush and going back to the previous shade, and I'm going to blend it over. Nice, nice shade. Okay, I am going to use a little bit of that redder shade on my lid. Okay, I'm going to go to the shimmers. I'm going to use this one first, which looks like a boring brown, but it's not. I'm going to spray it just to help against any fallout. Fortunately, it does not really translate the fact that it has a very, very cutesy green in it as well. Back to that redder shade and then to that brown to just make sure that it is blended in the outer corner. I am going to go to this one and then to that one. So I want it a little bit in the outer corner on my lower lash line. Kind of fade it in a bit. And then I'm going to go to that green. Also going to use that a little bit in the outer corner. And a little bit on the border here, just with the tip of this brush. Just to give a hint of, I don't know, something extra. Okay, I also want with this brush a little bit of that red matte. Just below the shimmers on my lower lash line. Because I'm wearing this as a blush as well, I'm kind of adding a little bit of blush here to connect everything. Because I think that looks fun. I'm just very lightly going in with my brush. Now this is depending on your face shape though. Just try it. Play around with it. See if you like it. almost done. We have one shade left, and that is the lightest one, which is not weird, right? Going to go in the inner corner, and I'm also brushing it over the other shades that I used. Then to add a little bit extra, I'm going to grab my face highlighter. I'm going to finish everything off and then I will be back and give you my thoughts on this palette. Oh, I apparently forgot an eye pencil. Well, that's okay. I finished off the look with Falsies from AOA Studio in the style Jean. And the lippy is from Odin's Eye. It is one of their matte lip stains in the shade Perfect Plum. I forgot eye pencil, but that is okay. So what do I think about this palette? I think that the color story is unique again. And I think that she is known for her unique color stories, right? There are two mattes in here and the rest are shimmers. I have more palettes of her that are, well, basically the majority are two mattes and then the shimmers. I think that the shimmers is... She's very, very good at the shimmers. The shimmers are stunning and they are also stunning in this palette. I did not have any creasing either, by the way, while I had the first look on for quite some time and I was sweaty and I was in the rain, no creasing whatsoever. I do feel that this is a palette that will pair very, very well with two of the other palettes that I will show you in just a second. And yeah, performance-wise, the shades blended very well. They layered very well. I do feel though that because of the tones of these two, it's not that you can basically make this one a lot deeper. Maybe if you start with this one and then blend this one over top, but because the tones are so very, very different, you can create depth, but you cannot stay in the own color family, if that makes any sense at all. So if you have, for instance, a light green and then a darker green to darken it up, it's still green. And this is almost more... Well, the chestnut, that is it. It is, when I see the chestnuts that we have here, basically the color that I have on my eyes is a chestnut. So she did that very, very well. Let me show you the palettes that I feel pair with this one very, very well. So let's go first to her first palette, which is this one, which is the Dragon. And as you can see, they will pair very, very nicely. Now, this is the only shade from her that I don't like. I like the performance, but I don't like the color because for me, it's not brown enough. Or it's too red. It's kind of both at the same time. And because this is a little bit redder, this one is better on my skin tone. This one just looks weird on me. However, I do feel that if I use this one and then deepen up with this one, that will work. And then you can also use these two together. So I feel like these two will complement each other very, very well. And then I also pulled the Gazelle. I feel like the Gazelle can kind of work with this one as well. Even though this is more of a cooler toned olive, this brown also has a hint of green in it. So I do think that you can combine them very well. And then when I look at the mattes and then especially these two shimmers, but also this shimmer will work very, very well with it. And yeah, these ones will work very well with this one again and even with the brown. So I think that that it is a little bit more of a continuation of her. Basically, you can see that she's more into the darker, grungier tones right now. And I think that this is a very much a fall or autumn palette, looking at the looks that I created. And yeah, performance wise, it did not disappoint. Then it is just a matter of color story, isn't it? I could get it through to pan. It's also the base that you use underneath. Now, I use the Natasha Denona base, which is a little bit more on the orangey side for me, which makes the shadows a little bit warmer. But yeah, you can just, you know, play around with the different bases that you have. And I think that is kind of it, guys. I will leave down below where you can find the palette. Let me know down below what you thought of the looks that I created. Did you get the palette? Are you skipping? Let me know down below. And then this is it for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.